Namayingo District is made up of three constituencies, which include Bukoli Islands and Namayingo South. Three quarters of the district is an island. The district is grappling with maternal and child deaths. Health officials want the government to improve on the health service delivery in the district.
As we speak now, we have 11 lower local governments, but with only one health sub-district, that is Buhinja Health Center 4, and only 9 health center 3s. We need a lot, we need more, especially in the islands. You discover that we have 3 islands. In those islands, we have 3 health center 3s, that is Lolwe Health Center 3, Sigul Health Center 3, and Rukana Health Center 3. But there are some other detached islands that can't access Lolwe, neither do they access Siguru.
According to the Assistant District Health Officer, Matthias Mangeni, the current state of child and maternal health in the district is worrying, and this is attributed to the poor infrastructure development in the region.
The communities that are in the islands, they face a lot of challenge when it comes to issues of child and maternal health. We have poor referral mechanism, and the cost of such delivery is also so high. Many partners who come to work with us, when they come without making assessment properly, they come and withdraw very fast because of the costs that are attributable to what they want to offer in the islands. And for that reason, as a district, we have always put this at the forefront.
Mangeni adds that women have to walk long distances to health centers to seek health services. As a result, many women have turned to traditional birth attendants, which puts their lives at risk due to lack of enough care.
Enrolled Namayingo to benefit from the boat ambulances, which has not yet come, and we hope that it will come. And if it comes, it will serve the gap in the referral mechanism. But also, we also need another ambulance on the mainland, because the journey will not be complete unless there is another ambulance on the mainland to continue with the referral.
This has prompted Code Aid to donate medical equipment worth 60 million Ugandan shillings to the health centers in Namayingo district, with the aim of improving health service delivery to women and children. The equipment has been received by Namayingo District Administration together with officials from the Ministry of Health.
Today we're very pleased to hand over the equipment, a sample of what you see here, to the district of Namayingo. Cordaid is working in 4 health facilities in the district on strengthening maternal health and postnatal health and postnatal care. The project is funded by private means from Cordaid, by private donors in the Netherlands. Totals around 1 billion for the entire project. And the facility, the equipment that we're handing over today for the 4 facilities, totals a bit around 61 million shillings.
Wow.
Namayingo District has a population of over 200,000 people, of which over 100,000 are female and over 106,000 are male, according to the 2014 National Population and Housing Census. The child and maternal mortality deaths are aggravated by the rampant teenage pregnancies on the islands. Meanwhile, the Rwenzori Diocese Bishop, Right Reverend Ruben Kisembo, has challenged the government to supply its health facilities with more maternal health supplies to solve the problem of maternal deaths in the country. The bishop was speaking today at the handover of maternal health donations worth 300 shillings to Kabarole Hospital. The donations include mama kits, mattresses, mosquito nets, and delivery beds, among others.
So the point is that the government and all stakeholders do the needful, especially the same mothers who are delivering not to die in the delivery process, and they are helped to deliver and they remain normal and the children should be also normal. They have been given to us free, and we don't expect now staff to begin getting money out of these items from the mothers who will come here for delivery. That's my expectation. They are given to us free, so they must also be given to the mothers free of charge.
Kabarore Hospital, Uganda's second oldest hospital, was founded by the Church of Uganda under the Rwenzori Diocese. Toro Kingdom praised the facility and the church for improving the health of the people in the region and challenged the government to give it a helping hand.
The church has come up with projects, agricultural projects. It is no longer an issue that you will pray and God will provide. The church is saying, you will work, God will bless. We want to thank the church for that.
Report by Jimmy Luima and Jonan Tusingwire for the news.